أيوب عليه السلام. أيوب عليه السلام, he had 14 children and he had great health and wealth. Everybody loved him. One day after 80 years, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took away all of his 14 children, one by one. Then he took away his wealth. Then he took away his health until the narration says that his skin used to fall off his body until you could see his muscles and his bones. And he's still alive, breathing. Not only that, the people began to say, if this man was a good person, Allah wouldn't have done this to him. And so he lost his close friends. One day his wife came in and said, Ya Ayyub, alayhi salatu wasalam, isn't it enough now? Can't you ask Allah to get rid of this? It's enough. We've gone through too much. Ayyub alayhi salam then said, my wife, how long did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give me blessings for? She said, 80 years or so. He said, I am too shy to ask Allah to cure me yet until 80 years of this time has gone as well, because giving me so much. It was after 7 years, however, when he saw his wife resorted to taking from her hair and selling it, that he said, Rabbi, Masani al-durru wa anta arhamur rahim. Even look at the way that the Prophet, he asked Allah to cure him. He didn't say, oh Allah, cure me. Oh Allah, you have harmed me. Oh Allah, you brought this sickness, take it away from me. No, no, no. He said, oh my Lord, harm has afflicted me. He didn't even attribute it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because when harm comes to a Muslim, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala afflicts you with some kind of hardship, it's actually good for you. I'm going to say the hadith in a minute. Wa anta arhamur rahimin, and you are the most merciful. Allah says, فَكَشَفْنَا مَا بِهِ مِنْ ضُرْ. We took away all the harm away from him. وَآتَيْنَاهُ أَهْلَهُ وَمِثْلَهُمْ مَعَهُمْ. We gave him his family back and his children back and double their amount. We gave him wealth. Grasshoppers, like the shape of grasshoppers of gold, began to rain onto Ayyub alayhi salam. Used to pick him up. And he used to, more than what he had. It's in the hadith, it says that he would go around and picking as much as he can so quickly. And then Allah sent Jibreel alayhi salam and said to him, Ya Ayyub, are you not already being given enough blessings? Why are you trying to hog everything up? In other words, take all the, don't worry, we're giving you blessings. Why are you so quick in wanting to gather it all? He said, Ya Rab, who is there that can take enough of your ni'mah, enough of your blessings? I'm gathering your blessing, Ya Rab. So a Muslim, Allah loves to see his servant taking from his blessing. He loves it. And thanking Allah for his blessing. If when in the hardship, they also thank Allah and they are patient. The Prophet ﷺ said, عَجَبًا لِأَمْرِ الْمُؤْمِنِ فَإِنَّ أَمْرَهُ كُلُّهُ خَيْرٌ. Strange is the matter of the believer, for anything that happens to him or her is good, subhanallah. He said, in asabahu khayrun shakar, when asabatu darra'a shakar, sabar. When something good happens to them, they thank Allah. When something bad happens to them, they are patient. Because Allah says in the Quran, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. We shall surely try you with a loss of wealth and wealth and fear and hunger and loss of lives and loss of fruits and food, and give glad tidings to those who are patient, to the ones who, when in a calamity befalls them, they say to Allah, we belong unto him, we shall return. They remember that this is a test.